again the same question about Turkey. How would you describe the political and social situation there?
Oh, the political situation in Turkey is very complicated because, as you know, Erdogan is the main fascist in country. It's very crazy. Turkey is like the first country for the account for the amount of arrested journalists in the world.
What kind of journalists?
Arrested. like imprisoned journalists in the world. And there are many, many prisoners, political prisoners in Turkey, each part of social movement. And also there are anarchist prisoners in Turkey. And
but let's talk a bit more about the people as a whole. I mean, not about the political movements, but first there is a ruling party, which is Erdogan's party.
Yeah, and it's very sad that half of the community, half of Turkish society, of Turkish people, they support Erdogan. They really support Erdogan. They really love him. And you cannot understand why, but they really love him. And mostly religious people and nationalist people, they support Erdogan. And they call him Reis as a Führer, as Germany. The German people, they were called, like as Hitler were called in Germany.
And
I think that there are... In Turkey, there are the problems. There are not only the government. There are very big problems with the society also, with the Turkish people, because they in my country, my people, they don't the elections are not true. They don't really support president or his he is not even any ideology, but they don't support him at all. But in Turkey, people are really. Like half of the population, they really support Erdogan, and after COP, they were really supporting them. Like they were crying out Allahu Akbar on the streets and with signs of nationalists. Mostly, as I mentioned, the nationalists and the religious people they support Erdogan.
And what about the other people like? I don't know, maybe more liberal people, anarchists, of course. Yeah, are there any socialists or something?
Yeah, in Turkey there are people from each ideology, and there's an anarchist movement in Turkey also. Mostly the anarchists, the socialists, of course, and the liberals, they're against Erdogan, but he's very strong and his party very strong, and that's why they cannot do something. In 2015, the Kurdish party of HDP, they firstly entered to the parliament with 13%. They expected just more than 8%, but they did 13%, and it was a very big achieve for them, very big achievement for them. But this year, months ago. Something like this. Erdogan government, they arrested the party rulers, the rulers of this party, and many members of this party, and supporters also. And I think that the situation in Turkey is just going down. And I don't know, Erdogan is a big dictator. Yeah, but an anarchist movement is there are also, of course, there are. Organizing some demonstrations against Erdogan, and we can mention about the Gezi movement in 2013.
So the anarchists were part of the organization.
Yeah, of course, they were. Anarchists were the most important part of the organization of the Gezi movement, and I think that the Gezi movement is a very big. Very important part of like the fight for the fight against neoliberal countries nowadays. I think that Gezi is really important, not just enough for Turkey, but for all of the world, because for this park, people organized, they came together and they didn't give this park for building the, for destroying and for building the department store. Yeah, I think that Gezi movement, like what we can mention, firstly it's about Gezi movement. It was really good. And for this time, I was not in Turkey, I was in jail. But my friends, many of my friends, they were in the park, they were like fighting against police. And until now, when they remember about the about these 15 days, it is just the best days of this of their life. Yeah.
Can you describe the anarchist movement in terms of organizations and groups?
There are many groups in there are many anarchist groups in Turkey. Most of them, especially most of them, located in Istanbul. But there are several groups in Ankara, in Izmir, also in Kurdistan part of Turkey, in Ahmet Diyarbakır. They have some connections with Rojava. They support as anarchists from all over the world. The anarchists in Turkey also support Rojava, and there are some problems, of course, for them because Erdogan government they called Rojava, and everything was happening there as terrorists. The people who are fighting for Rojava, who are fighting for freedom, are the terrorists for Erdogan. Of course, we don't say that the Rojava is an anarchist experiment. No, it is not like the ideal anarchist experiment, but it is very close to anarchism. It is the, it is more close to anarchism than the other ideal, than the other types of communities,
mm-hmm.
And that's why anarchists from all over the world they support Rojava and also. They said anarchists in Turkey. there are many anarchist prisoners in Turkey. I cannot count now. I cannot like. I don't remember all of their names. Yeah, of their names. But I know that there are many anarchists in many prisons in Turkey. Yeah, as I said, that mostly they are doing some demonstrations from time to time, like from Suruç, there were a campaign of Suruç, the anarchists. They like they came together and they wanted to go to Suruç to help people in like to help Syrian people and to work for Rojava. But when they on the way to the Suruç, there was a terror act against them, and many people, many anarchists in this terror act, they were killed. And anarchists.
This was.
In Suruç.
Yeah, but this was an act of ISIS, right?
I don't know, actually, if you cannot. I don't know, you cannot guess, but anarchists, they want from the court or from the government like to solve this, like who did this, but government are not interested in this problem.
Mm-hmm.
And every year and from time to time, they like in the anniversary of Suruç massacre, of Suruç terror act, anarchists came together and they organizing demonstrations against the terror. They show that they are against terror and etc. And there are anarchists in Turkey. They work in terms of problems of women in Turkey, in terms of like animal liberation, and of course the main things are the stateless and the state and the inequality.
About now we have two topics about отражава about the women, not the women, but the should, sex,
gender.
Yeah, yeah, the gender issue. So let's ask about Torjava first. How would you describe the relation between the, I mean, technically, how does it happen that the anarchists in Turkey have so much information about Torjava, and what are the relations between the Kurdish parties and the Turkish anarchists? I mean, do the Kurdish people recognize their movement as close movement to the anarchism, or it's more like the Turkish anarchists recognize the Kurdish movement like close to the anarchism?
Kurdish, you know, you mean Rojava or?
Rojava, yeah.
The movement in Rojava is a practice of democratic confederalism, and it doesn't matter how it calls Kurdish people or Turkish people, but it's like it's like this, and this idea is very close to anarchist movement, to anarchist ideology, and that's why anarchist Turkish or Kurdish anarchists, they support Rojava, what's happening there. I don't know many, I have no like so big information about the supporting Turkish anarchists in Rojava, supporting Turkish anarchists in Rojava. But I know that they support, there are some organizations as DAF and etc. They support like Rojava, because Rojava, it's the name of territory of the northern Syria, and it's close to Turkey. And Rojava has a as one of the social centers in Diyarbakir, in Turkey. And that's why they can like connect with Rojava from Diyarbakir, and there are many anarchists in Diyarbakir also. And DAF is very active in Diyarbakir also. Yeah, what I know about it is, and also Turkish and Kurdish anarchists in Turkey, they support Rojava and fighting for freedom of Kurdish movement in Rojava.
Mm-hmm. And now, I don't know, you missed the actual, I mean, what's happening, I mean, the understanding about our local situation. It is more like we are part of the, you know, Eastern Europe and almost Turkey and next to Middle East, but in Bulgaria it's more like they, I mean, including the women, they do not feel themselves, or they do not consider themselves oppressed. Officially, it was, if you look at the government politics, it's more like they are equal to the men for. For example, the first constitution after Bulgaria was created as a state, I mean the modern Bulgarian state, it included voting for women and voting for men. I mean, there was no difference.
Yeah.
And formally, it's more like we are equal. In practice, as I said, usually the women are the dinner and the men are talking to each other. So it's not that we don't have gender issues, but in Bulgaria we do not seem to recognize the gender issues. But still, from my perspective and what I have seen about Turkey and the Middle East, it's still very different there. So I would like to know more about the gender issues in Turkey and maybe in Azerbaijan and in Georgia, and how are they fighting about this?
From the side of rights in Azerbaijan and Turkey, like women, they have rights for vote or like rights for being parliamentarist in parliament and etc. Like in Azerbaijan, when firstly there was a like national government in 1918, before Soviet Union. Even then, women had like rights for voting. I don't know when in Turkey they started. I mean that it's from Atatürk, maybe. I don't know actually, but it doesn't matter that they. Okay, it's a very good point that women have rights for voting and rights for being like working in government or something like this. But it doesn't mean that they are equal with men in these countries, especially for the reason that there are Muslim countries and for Islam, for the religion. The women and men are not equal. The men also always like it's something like more important, or I don't know, more like better for religion. Of course, it's something better than women, and I don't know how many women in Turkish parliament actually, but there were some projects of HDP. A party like this Kurdish party, pro-Kurdish party, and they have many women in their like party, and they have also transsexuals and like all these minorities. Of course, there are big problems because in Turkey, especially because there are many cases that the families they give their daughters to the. Like for let's see
for sale
no like to husband
mm-hmm. Yeah, so basically I guess what you mean is that basically go and marry.
They give them marry, and it's like in very early age, very very early age, and it's in some regions. In Azerbaijan, there is this problem also, but I think that not so big as in Turkey. I don't know why, but in Turkey this problem is very very big, and there were. Sometimes, in like in this month, there were law projects which are protects the men who are raped. There were law projects for men who raped women, like who raped young girls and very very young girls. And I think that the government they are against the equality of women and men in Turkey, and they sometimes they support the other issues. In Rojava, there were experience of very big experience of fighting women, and I think that fighting for women, fighting for freedom, is very very important thing. And with this action, women they became more and more free for their own lives or in the understanding of the world and etc. And Rojava has a very big and has a very good experience on these issues, on the equality of men and women.
Do you believe that the anarchist movement in Turkey has any means to stand against the oppression of the government?
As what?
Has any means to stand against the oppression? I mean, what kind of ways do they have to defend themselves?
I don't know, when in countries as in Turkey or as in Azerbaijan, where the autocracy or the as you can call it, like dictatorship, when they want to arrest you, you don't have any choices. Like you just can run from the country if they want to arrest you. That's why the comrades in Turkey, whom I know, the anarchists in Turkey, they don't care about this mostly, and they work on their movement and they are trying to do something for their country, for their society. And they think that when the government will think about this, and when the government will think about the rest of this, the rest of them, they will do this. Like nothing, like any. They cannot. How they can defend it? I think that there is no way. If a government wants in such countries, they will do this.
Do you think that better relations, or that we could basically improve our connections with the Turkish anarchists, so we could both, or at least one of the movements, could benefit from this? This is more like a technical question, like you, for example, we in Bulgaria could benefit in this way, and the people in Turkey could benefit in this way.
I think that it would be better to speak with Turkish anarchists about this, and I think that, of course, it would be better to know the practice of Turkish anarchists for you, and it would be better for Turkish anarchists to know the practice of you, like what you are doing here, and maybe that you can solve some problems what are doing there in these situations, and maybe they can find some solutions of some problems that, like, you can do it. I think that it's very, very important to connect with each other, like, and especially if you are neighbor countries, and if you are neighbor country with Turkey. And I think that it is, from my point, it's anarchist movement in Turkey very, very important. Like, it is a very important movement for the world. Like one of the most important movements.